Hello everyone. So today we will be discussing about Python. So the question is, what is Python? So basically it is a programming language. But here is the definition of what is really a Python programming language. So a Python programming language is a popular high-level programming language used in various applications. So Python is an easy language to learn because of its simple syntax. So Python is very different from other language because they are having multiple syntax, or they have very different syntax. So Python can be used for simple tasks such as plotting, or for more complex tasks like machine learning. So Python is really used for machine learning. So next is variables, objects, and classes. So a variable is a reference to a value stored in a computer's memory. So variable, these are the things that we declare. So variables can be sorted into a variety of categories or data types, such as numbers. So for numbers, we declare as int or integer, float for those with decimal. Next is boolean values. So these boolean values only have the two values, which is true or false, and sequences for string, list, and etc. So an object is a collection of data from a computer's memory that can be manipulated. So these are the things or data that can be manipulated. So all variables are objects. So although some objects can be defined by data referred to by multiple variables, methods are the functions used to act on alter an object data. They describe what your object can do. So use methods or functions. Next is a class is a collection of objects who share the same set of variable or methods. So this is a class, this is the objects, and these are the instances. So our object has the instance of, first is it has a color name, color pink, and it has also a name of Polo. In the instance 2, it is color red and its name is Mini, and the third is color blue and the name is Beetle. So the definition of the class provides a blueprint for all the objects within it. So that's what we called as instances. So instances may share the same variables, color, shape, size, etc., etc., but they do not share the same values for each variable, blue, red, and pink. So the same, they may have the same variables, which is color, name, but they have the different values, because we have the pink, then we have the red, the blue, and the name is Polo, Mini, and Beetle. So next we go with the basic syntax rules. So the name of your variable, my, int, etc., is placed on the left of the equal operator. So this is our variable. My string, my int, my float, my list. So as you can see, my string is string. My int is 7 numbers without decimal. My float is numbers with decimal, with dot or with point. 7.0 is an example. Then my list is for an array, 7, 8, 9. Or anything inside this 2 bracket. So my boolean is having the value of true. It can be false, it can be true. So most variables names are in Camel case. Meaning of Camel case is, first word is small letter, then the second word is having a first letter in uppercase. So where the first word begins with the lowercase, this one my, so it begins with the lowercase, and any subsequent words are capitalized. So for example, my string here, if you put my string, so it should have the S for the capitalized. And if you have my string here, so we have the string, and here is an H for our capital letters. So variable names may also appear in sneak case, where all words are lowercase with underscore between words. So also we have the Camel case and snake case, where all the words are in lowercase with underscore between the words. So the assignment operator equals is the variable name equal to the memory location where your value is found. So this equal sign sets the variable name to the memory location. So what is the memory location? So this values. The value of your variable hello world is placed on the right of the equal operator. Then the type of this value does not need to be stated, but its format must abide by a given object type as shown. So these are the examples of the proper syntax rules. So these variables and these values are following the syntax rules in Python. So we go to our basic syntax rules for our function. So we call our function as def. This indicates that you are defining a new function. So def means defining. Function refers to the name of your function. So this one. Then by convention, this name is typically lowercase and represents a verb or action. So for example, def add, like one. So you use the verb in lowercase. Then eb, this one in the inside, refers to parameters. So these are the parameters, values or variables that can be used within the statements of your function's definition. If your function has no parameters, an empty parenthetical is used. So if you don't have the parameters, so you can use just the open and close parentheses. So the return statement is an optional statement that will return a value for your function to your original call. So it is an optional. So you could return or you could print. So we go to our next slide. So calling a function. So call the function by referring to its name, function, and by placing any necessary arguments 1, 2 within the parentheses separated by commas. My value equals function 1 and 2. So this is our variable and this is our function, and we have the two parameters, which is 1 and 2. So if you wish, you can set your function call equal to a variable my value. The value returned by the function will be assigned to your variable name. So next slide is common data types and operators. So what is a data type? So a data type means of classifying a value and determining what operations can be performed in it. All objects have a data type. So all objects have data type. Operators are symbols used to carry out specific functions and computation. So this is the example of our operators and this is our description. So for this one, double quotation, so we call it as exponentiation or raised to the power. And this one is a complement, unary plus and minus. Method names for the last two are plus at or multiply, divide, modulo. So we call the percentage as modulo in programming. Then floor division for double quote. So plus and minus for addition and subtraction, right and left bitwise. So we use this as our bitwise and for and symbol. Bitwise exclusive or unregular or, so we call this as bitwise on or. Then comparison operators, less than or equal, greater than or less than, greater than, greater than or equal to. So equality operator, so this will check if equal not equal, so it will check if operators are equal. So assignment operators, so what are the assignment operators? So this one will be for our operators. So we have the we have the equal sign, the modulo equal, division equal, bitwise equal, minus, subtraction equal, plus equal. Then we have this our exponentiation, or this is for multiplication. I didn't multiplication, and this is for exponentiation. So is not, so these are the identity operators. In not in, membership operators, not or and are logical operators. So here is we have the class and this their description. For the bool, we have the boolean value. So the boolean value is true or false. Int, meaning integer, arbitrary magnitude. Float, floating point number or those number with decimal. List, mutable sequence of objects or arrays. Tuple, immutable sequence of arrays, immutable. STR4, character string, set, unordered set of distinct objects. Frozen set, immutable form of set class. DICT or DEC, associative mapping, aka dictionary. So, DICT is dictionary. So, we go to next slide. For our common, this one. So, we have the input and output. So, what are input and output? So, input functions is allow users of a program to place values into a programming code. So, when once we call an input function, this one, so we ask the user to input from their computer, keyboard, or from their phones, keyboard, the, for example, this one, we have the enter a number. So, the user will enter a number. So, the parameter for an input function is called a prompt. So, this is called a prompt. This is a string. This can be indicated by double quote or single quote, such as enter a number. So, this is a prompt. No. The user's response to the prompt will return to the input statement called as a string. To use this value as any other data type, it must be converted with another function int. So, we call, once we prompt the users to input the or to enter a number, so it will be put in a variable x and the value will be converted to int, then we call the x string for our variable input. Then y equals x plus 2, so we also declare a variable y, so x plus 2. For example, if we enter a number 2, 2 plus 2 equals 4, then we print y, so the output should be 4. So print functions. So what are the print functions? So this is the format. Print, allow program to output strings to users on a given interface. The parameter of this function is not of any type. All types will automatically be converted to strings. So this is our input and output slides. So we go to our if else statement. So if else statement is very important in our Python or in a programming language. You really need to use if else to check if for check for equality or if it coincides with the function call. So if else statement. So this if else statements allow programmers to adapt the functions of their code based on a given condition. For example, if a given condition example is x modulo of 2 equal to 0, so if it is true, then the statement following the if statement will be executed. So if it is true, so the statement inside the if will be executed. If the condition is false, the statements following the else statements will be executed. This one. If x modulo of 2 equal to 0, this will print an even number. Else if x equal to 0, print this number equal to 0. Else if that this is not modulo to 2, or this is x modulo of 2 equal to 0. So this code, actually the if code, is asking if the given x given number is having the remainder of 0. So else this is an odd number, otherwise this is an even number. So the condition is tested using the boolean operators equal. So this is the boolean operators equal is equal to or is not equal to, and used to test multiple conditions and or used to test at least one condition is true. Additionally, else if statements or elif in Python can be used to provide Unicode statements for multiple conditions. So this one, we get the remainder. So if the remainder is 0, basically 2 divided by 2, so it will be 0. If the quotient is 1 and the remainder is 0, so this is 2 is an even number. Otherwise, if 3 divided by 2, so we have the 1 point something. So we have the 1 as our remainder. So the output is this is an odd or an add number. So we go to our next slide. So after our if else statements, we have the for loops. So for loops is very necessary for our Python or any programming language, because for loop perform the same task or iteration for the number of times specified by an iterable something that can be evaluated repeatedly, such as a list, string, or range. For defines the for loop. So once we call the for, so it defines already the for loop. X is the variable defining the number of times that the statements within the loop print my int are executed. So this is the variable defining the number of range So the range start, stop, and step. So 0, we start with 0. Then we stop at 5. Then the step is 1. So it would print as 1, 2, 3, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So by function is often used to define x. The starting value is defined by start. The final value is defined by stop. Stop minus 1. So once it goes to 5, so we have the 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 only. Because we define it by stop minus 1. And the magnitude of at which x changes between loops is defined by step, which is 1 in this example. So in is a Boolean operator that returns true if the given value is x found within a given list, string, or range, or etc. So once we have the Boolean operator that will return true if the given value of x is found within the range. So we start with 0 and we end with stop minus 1, so basically 4, and we have the step of 1 per loop. So another type of loop is while loop. So a while ago we are discussing about the for loop. So these two, for loop and while loop, is same in function but they are different in formatting. So while loops in Python are statements that iterate so long as a given Boolean condition is met. So as long as the condition is met, the while loop will be executed. So the variable x, so in this example we have the variable x determining whether or not the condition is met. So while x is less than 5, so the is defined and manipulated outside of the header of the while loop, while this one. So the condition is x is less than 5 is a statement containing a Boolean variable. So this is our Boolean variable. No. Break is a statement used to exit the current for a while loop. So once we have the break, it will exit the program. Then continue is a statement used to reject all statements in the current for or while loop iteration or return to the beginning of the loop. Right. So we have these examples here. We have the input or prompt, enter a number, then we declare the my int as our variable. When we put it into an integer, then we get the prompt input. So it will print with our my int. Okay. So this also prints out 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 because while true, print count. So we have the count plus equals 1. So the next iteration will be 0 plus 1 equals 1. If count is less than or equal to 5, so break. Or greater than or equal to 5, so it will break. So this one prints out only an odd numbers, 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. So for x in range, so range 10, so it will go with 10. So if x is modulo of 2 equal to 0, continue, otherwise print x. So if x is x modulo of 2, or the if we have the remainder of any numbers divided by 2, so it will print. So 1 divided by 2 is equals to 1, so it will print 1 because it is not equal to 0. 2 modulo of 2 equal to 0, so the remainder is 0 when we divide 2 divided by 2, so it will continue, it will not print because the actual output is just 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, and these are all odd numbers. So basically these are our discussions for our Python and its basics. So maybe that's all. You can subscribe to my YT channel for more, and we will continue it with our discussions for more. So thank you.